Welcome to the course on smart device application development with GeneXus. My name is Carlos, and I'm going to present a series of classes to explore the most relevant aspects of these types of applications. This course is divided into two levels. Level 1 will deal with basic topics related to the development of these types of applications with GeneXus. And Level 2 will cover more advanced aspects. In this level, we will deal with the following aspects. We'll start with the characteristics of these applications, the types of applications that exist, and the possibility of developing applications that only work online, or that also work completely or partially offline. Also, we'll talk about the underlying conceptual model, together with the objects on which it rests, and the architecture of the applications which are completely online. Next, we'll continue with the aspects related to the interface and user experience, the design, so important in these applications, and the basic controls that the tool offers. As for the development work, we will see how to program behavior and integration, and then an introduction to offline applications. We will also see how to deploy applications, and lastly, aspects related to security. During this course, we will use as an example an application developed with GeneXus 16, whose KB has been uploaded to our training site. This application is a simplified version of the GeneXus event application and will allow us to show its sessions, speakers, and other details about the activities offered at the event that takes place over the course of several days. Next, we will see the main characteristics of the application that we are going to build during the course. Let's see part of the application already developed at runtime. So let's access the application. Here we can see that the application is organized with a menu with tabs at the bottom. In the first section, we have access to a video presentation of the event. This video will be played from the cloud as it's published on YouTube using a specific control. We can see a list of featured speakers, and tapping on one of them shows detailed information of that speaker. The information is organized in sections. In the general section, we see the speaker's details, and then another one with the sessions in which he or she participates. The application is useful for both end users and back-end users. If you have editing permissions, you'll be able to edit that speaker's details. For example, you can change his or her name, and confirm the changes with this icon. And there we can see that the name has been changed. We could even delete it with this icon. Since in this case we don't want to delete it, we'll cancel this action with this other icon. We'll return to the Today section. And we'll find the possibility to see a list of restaurants near the event. We can see detailed information of the restaurants. And we can also see the previous list represented on a map. In the GX28 section, the keynote speakers of the event are displayed at the top. This grid has a different design and allows horizontal scrolling. Below, we can see an expanded list of speakers where all are presented, showing them in groups of three with horizontal scroll. Also, we see that some photos have been cut out. This is for users to notice that there are more speakers and intuitively leads them to scroll to access that information. Tapping on View All will allow us to access another list of speakers, which is the same list but with a different presentation. This list is part of the application backend, and if you have the necessary permissions, you will also be able to edit, delete, and even add information. There's also a list of tracks or topics related to the sessions. If we tap on one of them, we will see the list of sessions that deal with that topic. Finally, here in this section, there's a list of featured sessions, which are the sessions that have been marked as favorites the most times by all users of the application. In the schedule section, we will see the event program sorted by day. We can access each specific day using the tabs. On each day, the sessions are displayed according to their start time. We can start to mark each session as favorites, and tapping on one session shows detailed information about it. Again, this information is presented in sections, which shows the session's tracks and speakers. We can see that each session has this icon. This is to access additional actions that allow us to add a session to the calendar or send a tweet. In this case, we don't have Twitter installed in the device, so it doesn't show it. Or we can share information. In this case, it shows applications that can handle this content, email, messages, and so on. With this other icon, we can also access information about the room where the session is given. And with this little arrow, we can see and access a plan to locate the room where the session will take place. In the search section, we can make various searches. We will enter, for example, development. The text entered will be searched in sessions, speakers, tracks, rooms, and restaurants. The result is then displayed in different grids, each with its own format. Finally, we have the profile section, which shows the sessions that we marked as our favorites. A user account is required to access it, and if we don't have one, we can create it here. When we saw that only certain users can edit information and access certain back-end functions, we were talking about the user credentials used to access the application in this screen. We will enter with the user account previously created. Here we can also set user preferences, for example, if we want to receive notifications. We can log out of the application. In this link, we can view the logged in user's information. And by tapping on this icon, we can change the user's photo. So, what we've just seen is a summary of the application that we'll be developing throughout this course to explore the different features offered by the tool. This application is available for download from the training site. It's hosted in GeneXus server and called EventDay. With it, you'll be able, once the course is finished, to explore more advanced aspects that won't be dealt with in detail throughout the course.